Amidst the many challenges facing those who are struggling with regards to religious freedom, parents' rights, the sanctity of human life, we have some really bright light shining on the horizon through the United States Supreme Court.
President Trump has made a priority of remaking the nation's federal courts from the Supreme Court on down, and the results are beginning to show.
This Supreme Court recently, and through a number of cases, has made it clear that they are there to respect and defend the religious freedom rights under the First Amendment of the United States Constitution, for people in business, for public displays of symbols, for such as war memorials. We're very excited as we move forward to see a real groundbreaking change with regards to case law precedents to shore up these rights of parents and religious institutions and people in the workplace when it comes to their basic First Amendment civil liberties.
In its most recent session, the U.S. Supreme Court issued a ruling allowing the Bladensburg Memorial Cross in Maryland to stand.
When the court, in the majority opinion, said that religiously expressive monuments, symbols, and practices are now presumptively constitution, the court shifted the burden around and not only said that these veterans' memorials and like that are part of our history, part of our heritage, and are an important part of our country. No longer can someone just drive by, find themselves offended, and tear down the memorials through a lawsuit.
The Supreme Court also sent the case of Aaron and Melissa Klein, Christian bakers who declined to make a cake for a same-sex wedding, back to the lower court.
Specifically, the court said they need to look at this case again with reference to the Masterpiece Cake Shop case. That's the Jack Phillips case out of Colorado. And well, what do we learn from that?
In the Masterpiece Cake Shop case in 2018, a Supreme Court majority featuring Trump-appointed Justice Neil Gorsuch ruled that the state of Colorado had acted with religious animus toward Jack Phillips.
What the court is saying in Jack Phillips' case was that that was not a fair process at all. It was a bit of a kangaroo court. And I think we can prove very similar things going on in the state of Oregon as well, where we have the commissioner there saying that Aaron and Melissa Klein need to be rehabilitated. Well, innocent people don't need to be rehabilitated for simply operating their business according to their faith. In Aaron and Melissa's case, the state of Oregon imposed a $135,000 penalty against them. They issued a gag order against them. They couldn't even talk about their beliefs in the public square. That is not a neutral government towards the religious beliefs of its citizens. That is a government that is pronouncing them guilty of discrimination and punishing them for daring to hold those religious beliefs in public.
But still, concerns remain. The left continues to press its agenda, often ending up back in the courts. A Minnesota case could be headed to the Supreme Court, where officials helped a child receive a sex change operation over the objections of his mother. And the city of Philadelphia has stopped Catholic social services from placing children in foster homes because of their religious objections to same-sex couples. Thus, a city with over 6,000 children in foster care won't let one of the highest-rated foster agencies operate unless the Supreme Court overrules them.
The challenge is there. The cases we're taking on are horrific from a historical perspective, from a constitutional perspective. But at the same time, we see on the other front a revolution in our federal court system with new court appointees from the Supreme Court all the way down. They give us a lot of hope moving forward in the days ahead.